Welcome back to this DC Universe Online Let's Play. You're Sambo, and joining us is Jordan, our new level 3 character with her new light powers. And of course, if you joined us in the last episode, you'll know that we've got a newly created toon here, and of course we've used the new light powers. We're part of the Green Lantern Corps, as you can see from my glowing green ring there. Yes, okay, that sounds a little bit wrong, but you know what I mean. There it is. And we've got lots to do in this episode. Of course, we need to move along. We need to find our way around the safe house vendors. You can see there, if we have a look in our journal, we've got a mission here called Saving the World, tour the police station safe house. That's exactly what we're going to do. And of course, we're really keen now to, if we have a look in our K window here, to check out our new powers. And you may remember from the last time that we decided to go down the assault path here. All of this is brand new. So once again, I'm learning with you. I have no idea what I'm doing pretty much. So all this stuff is completely unfamiliar to me. And let's just have a quick recap of some of these powers, because I noticed a lot of you guys were saying, oh, what are all the powers like? Let's just have a quick another look at them. We've got one here called Minigun, which constructs a trio. That's three, get this, rifles to blanket the area with gunfire and to stun opponents. Absolutely awesome. We've got Spike Quake here, erupts spikes at the feet of nearby enemies to knock them down and cause damage over time. We've got Ram, smashes and flings enemies into the air. That one's gonna be awesome looking, I reckon. Ballistic Assault constructs, get this, a missile strike launching a devastating forward assault. We've got Lightweight, creates a light construct weight and swings it around to knock down enemies and provides protection against ranged attacks. Now, we've seen those weights being swung around by the NPCs when we've been fighting the Sinestro or the Corps in other episodes, so it's nice to be able to have one of them ourselves for once, of course. Strafing Run, this one sounds insane, requires level 8, generates a light construct jet, yes, a jet, to bomb enemies surrounding your target, setting them on fire and causing them to flee in panic. I mean, that just sounds absolutely insane. I can't wait to get that one. We've got to wait all the way till level 8. We're, level 3.5 at the moment. Whip Thrash punishes and stuns enemies. We've got Chompers, panics and causes damage over time to target and others in the area. We got another, we've already seen that one. Fan creates a fan construct to pull enemies towards you and knock them down. Now that again is another one that we've seen some of the NPCs using in the past. Very annoying if you're on the receiving end of it. Chainsaw mauls your enemies with a giant chainsaw. Can you believe that, folks? May panic nearby enemies. Of course they're going to panic. They see a giant chainsaw. And of course, luckily, down the end here, lucky last, we've got Snap Trap. Snaps and stuns a target with the jaws of a trap. So there we go. There's the assault hard light constructs there. Gosh, I certainly can't wait to get into those as we level up. So anyhow, first things first, let's find the vendors.
The vendors are where you go to repair any damaged equipment or sell any items you don't need. Some of the vendors sell unique items, and as soon as you have enough renown, you can purchase those as well.
Thank you for that, Oracle. In fact, let's have a wee look-see in here and see if we've got any repairs that we can do.
Equipped with the most advanced technologies.
Have we got anything to sell? We have. We've already got some vendor loot here, and you can see we're now on, big 125 cash. Yep, we are rocking it there. Now, we got some leggings and stuff here, but you can see the requirements are level 15, level 8, and in fact, level 30 there. So there's nothing we can buy just yet. All right, where's she sending us now? To the mailroom. That's where we do want to go because, as you can see, I've got some mail already.
Now, this is the mailroom with the mailboxes, of course, plus the watchtower teleporter, your PvP and alert holograms. Go ahead, check your mail. I sent you something. Then find Protostar Blakely. He has a message for you from Superman.
That we will do. There we go. A little something something from Oracle. Welcome to the good fight. Not everyone makes it out of those ships alive, and we still aren't sure what happened to those who don't. Yeah, I want to know what happens to them as well. So here's a little memento from me to honor your escape, and definitely check your email often. We can always use a hero with your kind of firepower. Good stuff. All right, so we've accepted that. Let's go straight into our inventory, check out what it is, and it's, oh, yep, a full domino mask there, not collected the style yet, and it gives us an extra 6 defense and 20 health, so we'll absolutely take those. And just reminding you guys too, if you do come back to DCUO, if you've had a bit of a break, you will get these in your inventory, and they are Lantern Core Deputization Decrees, and we'll just quickly go through them once again. They're account bound, so you can send them to other characters on your account, and basically what they do is allow you to become a member of the core, therefore giving you light power. So you can see there, the effects of using this item is that the power type of your character is changed to light, which is a controller variant. Now, if you have leveled up a character in the past, and let's say it's a, I don't know, a gadget and a arrow, what do we call them, a bow-wielding gadget person, and you want to be able to change to the light, so you can try out this new content, but you don't want to have to actually level a character from 0 to 30 all again, you can use one of these two tokens, and what will happen is that you'll be able to turn your existing character that you return to a light character with all of the abilities obviously able to be unlocked. You're going to have a whole bunch of skill and power points there that you'll be able to use, and you can see that what it does is it actually resets your current traits and it earns controller feats moving forward. So there you go. And one more thing importantly too, you do retain your currently achieved role-based feats from your other characters. So in other words, if you want to come back and give these new light powers a go, you can. You don't have to completely re-roll a new toon. Of course, you can if you wish. But it's a great idea, and you get a couple of them. Here we are, Protostar SL Blakely. We need to speak
Gorilla
to you.
Gorilla Grodd is attacking the Queensland Boardwalk. His army is devolving humans to apes, using some kind of tech even Star Labs hasn't seen before. We've got to get in there and stop them before they overtake Metropolis.
There we go. So we've got our cookie crumb quest to the Gorilla Grodd content, which of course is basically one of the first
Superman,
pieces of content we get.
I saw how you dealt with Brainiac. I'm asking you to help us with the situation here in Metropolis. With the Brainiac attacks, we need all the help we can get. Gorilla Grodd's army is attacking and devolving humans into apes. We've got to stop them before they overtake Metropolis.
No problem, Soupy. Here we go. Go to Metropolis to continue your mission. Let's have a look at the journal here. Go to Boardwalk Beach. No problem. So it looks like we're going to be able to head straight into some combat action. By the way, I don't know if you've noticed, but there's a whole bunch of new players roaming around now. And of course, that would be because they're all wanting to try out these new light characters. So yes, there's going to be an overabundance of light characters running around. But hey, that's okay. Anything that works to get people back. And you know what it seems to be? There's a lot more people running around the servers now than there were a couple of days ago prior to the release of the DLC. And there, look at that, even just out the front, we had a couple of people standing right there, and they're all green. Very cool costumes. It's awesome, isn't it? All right, so we need to head over here. It's just over the side to the Boardwalk Beach, you may remember from our other characters.
Trying to stop Grodd's gorillas at the Queensland Boardwalk, but they're using tech even Star Labs hasn't seen in action before. See what you can do about shutting this down.
Alright, so we have to defeat Gorilla Scouts, 15 of them. Let's use our new claws, and of course we've got our staff. Loving these new abilities. We've only got like a bar and a half to go, and we will be leveled up. And hopefully that means we'll be able to get some new cool stuff, some new abilities and powers. There we go, 3 out of 15, and we need to also retrieve invasion maps from the Gorilla Scouts. And of course they drop off these guys, and you'll see them as big question marks. Now, one thing we don't have, remember folks, too, is super speed. Of course, we get that much later on in the piece. Gosh, we're really cleaning up here, aren't we? This is amazing. And there's Switchblaze giving us a hand over there. Hello. And they just leveled up by the looks of things. Congratulations to you. Oh, I'm loving these abilities, seriously, and loving the staff too. A couple of you guys were asking, hey Sambo, what do you think of the staff? I really like it. It's nice and fast, and it's got some really cool combat animations, and you know how much of a fan I am of really cool animations. There we go, by the way, that big question mark there, that was one of the invasion maps. That's what they look like. They'll just randomly drop off these scouts. And we seem to be cleaning up absolutely no problems. That's okay. But you might remember from our last 3 toons. Yes, it's been 3 now. There we go, level 4. Congratulations, Jordan. That it's very easy at the beginning, but then you sort of hit this really hard difficulty curve just after level 10. So yeah, just got to be a little bit careful once we hit that sort of level. But we're okay for now, because of course they make it nice and easy right at the beginning. Alright, let's see if we can head over here and grab our very first collectible. Fantastic. There we go. And it does happen to be green, of course.
Gorilla Technician Report. General Grodd brilliantly designed this to shred upon impact, ensuring maximum devastation.
Alright, now this is the fun part, folks. What do we want? Do we want the minigun, which constructs a trio of rifles? Or do we want a spike quake? Or do we want a ram? You know what the answer is, don't you? That's right, it is... Da-da! Purchase minigun. Now let's have a look at this. Tap melee is a whip thrash times two, and hold melee is snap trap. Right, so I'm not sure how these work, but let's give it a go. We'll try it out on some of the mobs. I had some of you guys very nicely explain to me how this works, but I'm still a bit confused. Let's try it. Two. Oh, look at that! Look at that! Oh, that was fantastic, folks! Our first hard light construct. So we do the first... Look at that! That is incredible! Okay, so I'll explain what I'm doing here. I'm getting far too excited. I think if I just hit two, nothing happens. Oh, it does happen! Oh! Okay, so I thought I had to hit number one first, and then only then was I able to actually pull up the miniguns there, but it seems like I can actually just cast them by hitting number two. Very cool. Anyway, we get ourselves a new set of hands. Look at that. 17 health, 23 health, 6 precision. Sorry, 17 defense and 3 might more. Very good.
As if Brainiac weren't bad enough.
Alright, sorry, I was talking over the top of you there, Oracle. Here's some background intel. Gorilla Grodd is a hyper-intelligent ape who hates humanity. He believes apes, meaning himself, should rule, as if Brainiac weren't bad enough. Alright, first things first, let's go in and equip this new set of gloves here. There we go, because of course we didn't have any gloves before. And just once again reminding you, you won't see the style appear because I've actually locked, you can see here, I've locked all of our styles just so we retain our look, because you know what I'm like. I like to keep our look consistent throughout the series. Alright, what do we have to do? Travel to the Queensland Boardwalk. Alright, we will
do
that.
Those gorilla troops are trapping civilians with Grodd's devolution devices. Destroy the devices and weaken Grodd's forces.
Protect the fuel cells.
Hey, so you should know that people everywhere can use your help. Usually you'll find them near crisis spots in the city. Here's one. See if you can lend a hand.
Look at that, folks. Is that not just the best ability ever? Seriously. I just can't get over that. Miniguns. I'm constructing miniguns. Hard light miniguns. That is just awesome. Goodbye, Gorilla Soldier. Look at that! That is just amazing. I love it. Oh, this is going to be the best fun ever. Now, by the way, folks, a couple of you are asking, hey, what's the release schedule moving forward and what is happening to Definity? Oops, we got stunned there. What we're going to do... Oh, not sure why it was aiming over there that time. What we're going to do is, whilst we carry on leveling up Definity, is we're going to alternate between the two. So what that means is an episode of... An episode of Definity and then an episode of Jordan here. And we'll just basically flick between them, one on, one off. And we'll keep doing that, of course, until Definity reaches level 30. And then we'll carry on with this character. Plus, what we'll do also is we'll mix up some end level content. So we'll get on Blaze Purple and we'll have a look at some alerts, etc., for the end of game content as well, because I know a lot of you are wanting to see that. Alright, we have to find Lieutenant Harlan. Here he is.
Grodd's teleporters run off fuel cells. The more we destroy, the fewer troops they can bring in. Think you're up for it?
Alright, here we go. Look at this. All of these objectives now. We have to disable gorilla teleporters. We have to destroy fuel cells, destroy devolution units, defeat gorilla soldiers, and defeat gorilla lieutenants. So, boy, we've got our work cut out for us, I'll say. First things first, though, look at this. A collectible in a very odd place there. And that is an actual collectible, by the way, so it's an item. Oh, and another one! Fantastic! This will be an investigation, I'd say.
Gorilla Technician Report. This chassis is infused with a metal alloy so advanced, the humans' primitive weapons won't even leave us. Protect the fuel cells!
Alright, so I'm pretty sure it's these fuel cells here. Yeah, there you go. You can see now we've got 2 out of 20 of them down. And these are... what are these? I think these are the Devolution. Yep. Devolution units. They are indeed. And I'm not sure what the teleporters look like. I can't remember. It's been a while since we've played this, but I'm sure we'll find them a quick smart. But again, yes, we've got no super speed, so it's a little bit slow flying around. We'll, you know, more than made up for by the fact that we have these amazingly cool hard light constructs at our fingertips. So much fun. Seriously, can it be any more fun? Miniguns, folks! Miniguns! Just fantastic. Alright, so how many fuel cells have we got? 8 out of 20. We've got 4 out of 10 of the Devolution units. And we'll just hold back on... oh no, we won't. Look at that. Minigun time. No, he kind of seemed to interrupt that, actually. For some reason, I've locked onto these power fuel units. Power units. The fuel cells, rather. And there we go. Run out of energy, so we can't use any of our cool hard light constructs, unfortunately. Now, this is going to be a bit interesting because, of course, on this character, we don't have any self-heals. So we're going to have to be just a little bit more careful than we were on Definity, because we can't rely on those heals. Look at that! Up close and personal with the hard light construct. Get miniguns there. That is just fantastic. Absolutely loving this. Seriously, so much fun. If you've taken a break from DCUO, come on in. The water is fine. Roll yourself a character, a light character. And of course, that means you're either using fear or will, to find, depending on which faction you go for. And it is super fun, as you can tell. Oh, woohoo! All right. Look at those claws. They're just awesome. All right, time to use the guns. Booyah! This is just, seriously, it's too much fun. It is so much fun, it is criminal. I am a superhero being criminal with how much fun I am having on this character, seriously. Great stuff.
Protect the fuel. It is
minigun time! Now, I wonder if I'm cancelling those miniguns by actually melee attacking. What we'll do next time is actually just let them run. Let's see what happens. Yeah, okay, I think I am cancelling them inadvertently a little bit early, just because I'm actually using my melee ability before it finishes its cycle. So yeah, it's probably not the best. Now I'm also looking forward to some combos, and of course combos are what is going to make... is going to power our staff. So obviously the skills here are all about the hard light constructs. However, our actual combos will come out of... or is it the other way around? Actually, we should probably check before I go babbling on. Powers and skills. Sorry, yep. So skills are the weapons. So there we go. All of our combos for our staff. So I'm really looking for that now. Oh, I forgot. Look at that. I already forgot that we already had a combo, which is hold down the right mouse button. There we go. It's that focused spin, and it seems to do a bit of an AoE blast at the end of it. Oh, and those were those Devolution units too, by the way. They're little bullet-looking capsules on the ground. Let's try one of that, the combos again. So there we go, focused spin and letting it go, boom. And that basically one-shots them, which is fantastic.
Do not let them destroy the
fuel. I'll admit it, I'm really looking forward to getting some more combos too, because I'm sure with the staff they're going to be really, really cool in terms of their animations as well. Gee, those minigun things, minigun hard light constructs there actually knock back as well, which is fantastic. Boom. Alright, so what do we need to do now? Devolution units, 8 out of 10.
Help me. Grodd is in my mind.
9 out of 10. And leaping over to the last one there. All done, there we go. Alright, we need these soldiers. We've got 19 out of 25.
Protect
And we still need some lieutenants as well, so we're probably going to have to have a bit of a hunt around for them. And I think the lieutenants are, yeah, there we go. You can see one in the background. Another player attacking one. There's one there. Let's lock onto it just so we can grab it. The lieutenants have their body armor on the top there. That's how you can sort of separate them and identify them from the normal soldiers. So let's look for some more of those. There's one.
Fuel cells protect the fuel cells.
Oh, and they despawned. That's interesting. They kind of went out of range. We had a whole bunch of them over here, and they just disappeared. That was very weird.
Pound them.
Oh, well, look, if you soldiers want to fight, if you're following me, then a fight is what you shall get. Here, have some miniguns. Minigun to the face. And look at this. There's so many players wandering around. It's fantastic. It's just like the old days back at launch when we had lots and lots of players roaming around. This is good for the game, good for the population, hopefully also means good for endgame as these characters level up as well. All right, let's do our combo. Hold down the right mouse button and boom at the end. Nice. Finish them off with our claw leap. All right, 8 out of 10 lieutenants down. We need two more. Let's see if we can find them. Such a cool area around here as well. And it's good too. It's nice to break in gently. It's a nice, easy zone. It's not too hard. You'd be very strange if you actually died on these quests here. Oh, and we got stunned. There we go. Oh, 8 out of 10. Why did that one not count? That's interesting. All right, 8 out of 10. We need two more. Alright, there's one down there, maybe. Oh, that's because the green was a smasher, not a lieutenant. Whoops.
Do not let them destroy the
Let's lock onto him. Let's try our combo. And there goes another one over there. Let's grab him before someone else does.
Protect the fuel cells.
And there we go, use the breakout ability 5 times, get ourselves a feat. Time for a minigun. That is just awesome. So there we go, achieve level 5 to begin legendary battles. Already a level 5, how's that? Congratulations to you, Jordan. You're doing so well. Let's get out of here. Oh, we want to fight? A fight you shall have. Have some miniguns as well. No, it's all my pleasure. All right, we need to open our skill tree, hit K, because we've now hit level 5. How fast was that? It's just awesome, isn't it? All right, here we go. And what have we got? We've got a skill point. Here it is. This is what we were after. So we can put a point into staff now. We've got the focused spin there. Looks like we're being forced down the middle tree now, which is the sweeping slice. Interrupts and deflects enemy attacks with a surprise strike with additional damage and knockdown when the supercharge is at maximum. And that's holding down the left button. So let's learn that and give it a bit of a spin. Take it for a spin on one of the local gorillas down here. Before we update our journal.
Protect the fuel cells. Devolution fuel cells under attack.
That was it. Sweeping slice. Alright, so it's nowhere near as exciting to look at as the focused spin.
Do not let them destroy the fuel.
Oh, it's pretty cool actually, if you see it up close. It's not bad. Oh, and it's actually got a leap forward as well. So if I hold down the button, let's see. Yep. Alright, so that's a closer there, so we can close right into melee range without having to actually use any of our abilities, which of course uses up our power. So that's good to know. I didn't realize it actually zoomed us in there. Like a charge from WoW, if you like. Who is that?
I'm not afraid of you.
Yeah, okay, I can start seeing now that these abilities strung together are going to form some really powerful attacks. And, of course, they're just going to look awesome as well. Excuse me. All right, there we go. Let's get the heck out of here. We'll just perch ourselves up here for a second and take a look at our journal. Guerrilla warfare all done. Complete.
Grodd's usual trick is mind control, so I'm betting that's part of those devolvers. Grodd turns people to apes, then controls their minds. And he considers us uncivilized villains.
That's right. Okay, what do we have to do now? Hack Grodd's gorilla neural arrays and defeat Gorilla technicians.
Now that Grodd's main force is weakened, we need to help those devolved citizens. Grodd has neural arrays clustered on rooftops nearby to reinforce his devolution devices. Take those out, and you can create a device to reverse the devolution effect. The Flash is going after Grodd in his hideout. This should be over soon.
All right, you heard the man. We've got to take out these neural arrays. Now, he said that they're up the top on rooftops, so we'll go right up here because we're in the zone. Don't seem to be any around. Maybe, is it these ones, perhaps? Ah, it is two. All right, well, at least they're on a platform, so they're nice and easy to spot. Oh, seriously, I'm loving these abilities because, of course, you know how much I love my charge ability, and I'm really pleased that we've got one. Whoa. That was a big knockoff. And how cool do these things look? Look at these floating above the city here. Very awesome. Yeah, I'm really glad that I went for the staff. Seriously, something just a bit different from normal. And they, you know what, these combos just play into each other so, whoops, play into each other so well as I leap off the edge, plunging to my possible death. Never mind. Whoops.
Malfunction detected. Systems
And again, using my charge ability here just to get up close rather than the claw, because of course that saves on the old energy, but I'll use the claw now to get over there. Loving it. Alright, now that was very interesting. I don't know if you saw that the minigun hard light constructs actually appeared there. I did not hit button number two. Now, I think somebody tried to explain this to me in the comments of our first Jordan video. I must admit, I don't quite get it yet. But I'm pretty sure we can activate them depending on how many taps we give it. Kind of like an auto-activate, if you like, once we've actually done the first part. I think that's what they were trying to say, is you can actually key the other constructs with a power interaction. And of course, that's what the red swirling lights are around me. When that's going on, I think we can then do button combos to bring out the other hard light constructs. I think. Perhaps if I've got that wrong, you can correct me in the comments below. I'm pretty sure that's how it works. it's going to take me a number of episodes to get over how awesomely awesome that is. Seriously, that is just fantastic. I'm loving these powers. Oh boy, the fun is back in the game.
Mind control device engaged and operating at full capacity.
Good. Until that device loses power, you can free people from Grodd's devolution effects. Help citizens and get that tech off the streets.
And there we go, lucky last, we are done. Don't think we have to actually turn this one off, but hey, seeing as we're here. Oh boy, this, seriously folks, again, if you've taken a break from DCUO, now is the time to come back. You can see we've got players running around everywhere, we've got all of these awesome new powers, and it is just super, super fun. And of course, this is just from the good side, from the green core, the core side, and of course, there's the whole yellow side as well, the Sinestro, I'm guessing, if you decide to play a super villain. Anyhow, let's have a look at our journal as we run out of time. What do we have to do here? We've got to destroy Grodd's fuel cells on the boardwalk, and then gorilla teleporters are supplying the front line with fuel cells. Disable the teleporters to disrupt the supply line. We've got 0 out of 5 of there done. We've got to speak with Officer Vega, and that hasn't been done. And we've also now got to defeat and re-evolve citizens as well. So we've got 3 missions there all keyed up for us for the next episode. Certainly hope you enjoyed this episode. So much fun. Again, I'll say it till the cows come home. If you've been taking a break, come back. The DLC content is free if you're a subscriber. I'm pretty sure. Oh, actually, come to think of it, if you're not subscribing at the moment, maybe you do have to pay for it. You know what? That's something that we'll have to go and investigate. I'm not sure. Maybe as a reward to those who stuck with the game, maybe it's free and maybe it's actually purchasable if you weren't a current subscriber when it was released. Maybe you guys know. Maybe you can let me know in the comments below. But anyhow, folks, look at that. We are moving along nice and fast. We've got ourselves a pair of shoes there. I think they're going to, yep, way better than what we've got. What's that? That is a collectible. We'll absolutely collect that. And we've got ourselves, what's that? Some hands. They're our old hands. So all of this here is vendor junk. And of course, we'll sell that off at some point in the next episode after we've attacked these new three quests that we have here. So there you go, folks. I certainly hope you enjoyed it. And of course, more importantly than that, I hope you'll join us in the next episode as we go through our tree here, looking at our assault. What's up next? We've got the Spike Quake and we've got the Ram. And then after that, at level 8, we've got these crazy ones coming up here. The lightweight there, and of course the one I'm really looking forward to, which is the strafing run, basically the airstrike. That is going to be absolutely insane. And you can see we're leveling very fast. We're already level 5 and a third. It won't be long before we're 8 at all. So that's it. On behalf of myself, Sambo, and of course Jordan, our wonderful new light-based staff-wielding superhero, it's us saying take care. I hope you're having a great day. We'll see you next time, and bye-bye.